بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وبه نستعين.
ما هم بأمة أحمد لا والذي فطر السماء، ما هم بأمة خير خلق الله بادئا وانتهى. ما هم بأمة أحمد لا والذي فطر السماء، ما هم بأمة خير خلق الله بادئا وانتهى. ما هم بأمة أحمد لا والذي فطر السماء، ما هم بأمة خير خلق الله بادئا وانتهى. ما هم بأمة سيدي حاشا فليسوا الأكفياء، ما هم بأمة من على الأفلاك قد ركز اللواء. من حطم الأصنام، من أرسى العدالة والإخاء، من أسمع الدنيا حدا المجد فاشتعلت حدا، من قاد قافلة السلام وفجر الصحراء ماء واستمطر التاريخ فانهمرت سحائبه ثرى وغزى الظلام وجاء
الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله، أدى الرسالة وبلغ الأمانة ونصح الأمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده، وتركنا صلى الله عليه وسلم على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك ولا يتنكبها إلا ضال. ثم أما بعد، يا أيها الذين أمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. يا أيها الذين أمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. My dear brothers,
these kind of people are direct enemies to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and direct enemies to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, those who are quarreling and who are working and who are opposing the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the religion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, i.e. diverting their way from the way of Rasulullah and the believers, those are the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised them the great suffering. And those are the people who have associated with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because if you divert yourself from the way of Allah and the way of Rasulullah and the way of the believers, that implies automatically that you have imposed shirk on yourself and on the others whom you are in control with. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has exposed them for those who are not ruling by his sharia after the sahaba have fought all the way from all Muslims in all Muslim lands. If you turn every stone between your land of origin and Mecca and Medina, you could chase some of the blood of the Sahaba underneath this stone. This is to implement the Sharia. And here we come with some people from our color, they speak with our tongue, suddenly they scrap the Sharia. And if it was scrapped from the people before them, the predecessor, they endorse that and they make sure that they go in the same dirty way. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have said, O you believers, do not raise your voice on the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, otherwise your deeds will be abolished, demolished, will be invalid. If Allah does not allow any believer, even if he is a true believer, to raise his voice in the front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said your deeds will be invalid. Without you feel, without you know. Because once your deed is finished and is invalidated, Allah is not going to send you one of the angels to tell you, all right, Mr. Muhammad or Mr. Ahmed, your deed have been finished. No, you will know that in the hereafter. If Allah did not allow that, not allow to raise our voice in the front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to put our dirty hands on the mouth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell him you don't speak anymore, we do. You don't rule anymore, we do. You don't judge anymore, we do. You have no followers anymore, we do. Would Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow that? This is what's happening now. The whole sharia of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is being scrapped and people are are making a buffet out of it. They take what they like, they leave what they like, they impose what they like, they demolish what they like, they penalize what they like, and then they look at the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Anybody is opposing what our decisions? Here is the prisons. Here is the torturing. Here is the eliminations. Here is taking your wives to prison to rape them. Here is what we're going to control you with. So those are the people who are putting their dirty hands on the mouth of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Don't rule anymore. You are something of the past. We will love you at the mosque. We will announce that. But no way we're going to give you power. You or your followers or the followers of your companions. This is the language. This is the body language. This is the reality of what you are living now. And because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did punish us. Did punish us through our children, through ourselves. Humiliation imposed into us. Because we are not a true believer. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described a true believer. He said in Surah Ash-Shura, وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَهُمُ الْبَغْيُ هُمْ يَنْتَصِرُونَ. And those, if humiliation and wrongdoing is imposed upon them, they will be victorized. They will be victorious. They will be victorious. They will not take it. In Surah Ash-Shura, it's a description for the believer not to accept this wrongdoing, to do something about it. Even if he is being defeated at one battle or at one situation, struggle should continue. The Sharia of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because of the Sharia, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have stopped his maintenance. Because of the Sharia, because of these people are also building and making bridges between them and the Christians and Jews and the enemies of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is punishing us because of them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exposed them again in the surah of Al-Ma'idah on the table. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, if they did believe, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, as a reason for them to become a disbeliever, the children of Israel and their followers, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the children of Israel, they have been cursed on the tongue of Jesus, peace be upon him, and on the tongue of David, because they never used to forbid any wrong amongst themselves. He said again, and also, he said, you see them, you see many of them. يَتَوَلَّوْنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. They ally themselves to the disbelievers. You see many of them ally themselves to the disbelievers. And then he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and if they did believe in Allah and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and what has been revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they would have never taken them alive. But most of them are a disbeliever, fasiqeen. In the other ayah he said, most of them, they're gonna abide in the fire hell. In the meantime, this is what they're doing to the believers. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Imran, they torturing them, they killing them, they executing them, they putting them in prisons, they take their money, they take their wealth. And not only that, they also make sure that their children are not going to follow the same way as the father, as their holy fathers, the defenders of Islam. The defenders of Islam, now they go to prison, and their children, nobody looks after their children. And the children become drug addicts because of the imposing of the government to their family, poverty, and taking them out of schools and pushing them to the ages of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described these people. He said, those who disbelieve in the revelation of Allah, and they kill the prophets, and they kill those who enjoin in the good and forbidding the evils among these people, those people have no good actions accepted from them, and they are abide in the fire hell. And these are the disbelievers from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the description in Ala Imran. So their action because of not ruling by Allah's religion, they're being described as a disbelievers. Their action because they are taking their unbelievers alive has been described as an unbeliever. Their action with regard to humiliate Muslims and push them to the edges of the life and taking every right from them because they say Allah is the ruler have been described as disbelievers. So who's defending them amongst you? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, ها أنتم هؤلاء جادلتم عنهم في الحياة الدنيا فمن يجادل الله عنهم يوم القيامة أم من يكون عليهم وكيلا. Here you are arguing on their behalf on this life. Who will argue on their behalf in the hereafter in the front of Allah? This is a threat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for those who are arguing on their behalf on this life, that Allah is telling them, you will stand before me and I will let you to argue on their behalf and you will see where you're going to go. You will go nowhere but where they go. This is a threat from anybody who is defending these kind of evil rulers. And tell me by Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He promised the believers maintenance. Tell me, a country as Algeria, half the size of Europe, it has got the best quality of petrol. It's got forests. It's got seasides. It's got minerals. It's got populations, young population, not old and gay population like in these countries. Young, strong population, educated, can't feed itself. Iraq, land of honey and money. Can't feed itself. They said because it can't export petrol. So what? Who stopped the chicken from laying eggs? Who stopped the cow from producing milk? Who has stopped the sheep from proliferating and feeding Muslims? Who has done that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because of these rulers and because we are not taking a proper steps. Those who have feared Saddam and the people like Saddam, they did not enjoy in the good and forbid the wrong. What happened to them? How many extra years have been living? They have been killed like rabbits in bunkers, like mice in bunkers, by thousands and hundreds of thousands. So enjoying the good and forbidding the evil, it doesn't keep your life any longer, and it doesn't keep your money anymore. You have to understand the logic. Allah is the source of money. Allah is the source of aid, of power. Allah is the source of income and the length of life. So why we are afraid? This is the situation. For us to be believers, we have to impose again the Sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Sharia of Rasulullah. And this is what Allah promised. He's telling you in the country. And if, as Allah said in Surah Al-Ma'idah, if they have implemented their holy books, He's talking to Jews and Christians. If they have implemented the Torah and the Injil, they would have been eaten from above them. And they would have been eaten from beneath them. But most of them are miscreants, fasiqs. So you know now the source. You know now why you are poor, why you are coming to take grants and income from the lands of Kufr. It's because your Sharia is not applied at your country. And if it was applied at your country, that Allah will give you maintenance. And these people will come to your country begging in your doors. But now because you have skipped, because you have left the right of Allah to go, Allah let your right to go as a punishment. Your right has gone since Allah's right has gone. But because we only stand for our stomachs and our pocket money, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala imposed that humiliation into us. It will not be withdrawn, this humiliation, this poverty, this fear, it will not be withdrawn unless we stand first for the right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the right of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and to keep the work of the Sahaba intact because of us. Otherwise, it will not be imposed. After that, after we bring the right of Allah back, which you have been entrusted with, then automatically our rights will come. My dear brothers in Islam, the rulers of our Muslim land nowadays, those who have Muslim names and kafir actions, Muslim appearance and kafir behavior, Muslim tongue and twisting their tongue with the kafir speech when they are among the kafirs. We hear the real statements in the media of Kufr, and we hear their statements among its Muslims in the occasions of Eid and this and that, just to say that we are still Muslims. Every one of them, when he does a lot of mischief, a lot of disbelief, and a lot of Kufr, every now and then he goes and he announces he's going for Umrah. Here, I'm still a Muslim. Come on. I'm renewing my oath with Allah. Don't kill me. Don't push me. Don't get rid of me. I am doing Umrah. He kills Muslims. He put them in prison. His prisons are full. And all his establishments are against Islam. And every now and then he goes and he renews his life. He renew his oath in the front of the eyes of people so the fools and the ignorance can say, oh look, our president or our king is doing Umrah. How come you say he's this and that and the other? Without paying one visit to the torturing prisons in our countries. Without paying one visit to the establishment which is which is against Islam and Muslims. Yet, we still have not talked about what he did to the believers of the Ummah. After he had changed, after these rulers have changed the law of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and opposed Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and stopped him from his speech and stopped his sharia from applying among his people, then what they did, they took the people who were enjoying the good and forbid the evil, and they put them inside prisons, and they tortured them, separating their families, putting them in agony. And those who have resentment inside their hearts, but they cannot announce with their tongues, they give them difficulties. Although the countries will have oil, money, this and that, you will see poverty imposed upon people deliberately, because they want people to work day and night, and the little time they have to spend it trying to buy a bit of meat or a bit of food for their children. So they cause deliberate shortage in food, deliberate shortage in life, so people will have no time at all to spend anything for Islam. And the most they could do, if they have a little time, is to go and try to pray their five times a day or have a wash before they come to Friday. So there is no time left for Islam. Well-designed program. And what is more evil, while parents are struggling to bring up a family, while parents, good parents, are struggling to bring up Muslim child, they bringing him up as a Muslim child until the compulsory days of education of the tyrannical rulers. A Muslim child will become a good Muslim child until he's the age of 5 if he has good educated, God-fearing parents. When he reached the 5, he entered the establishment of kufr, the establishment of education, the establishment of twisting minds of children, the establishment of preparing soldiers for the tyrants to fight Islam and Muslims, to fight real Islam and Muslims. They are not going to fight the black stone in Mecca. They are not going to fight yet the mosques directly and the walls of the mosques. They are not going to tear the Quran off yet. They do that behind bars in the front of the people who cannot say. But they will fight Muslims who try to apply Islam. The orders from the West and the orders from the people, the devils, the order for them is never apply the law of Islam, because that will show people real Islam and that will make them good Muslims. This is not wanted. A child goes into this establishment. What does he find? He finds the most humiliated among the teachers is the teacher of religion. His subject is not added to the overall marking. So why should a child study his subject? He is not respected. His salary is the lowest among the salaries. If he's learning about the Sharia, or if he's even a scholar, you will see the Christian person who's teaching English, he has much bigger salary, much respect. He's got a car, and he's this, and he's that, and he's the other. And plus above all that, you will find that his subject which he's teaching is got the highest remark. And if he's failing his subject, means you have lost 1 year of your education. This is what they find. A total war in the mind of a child since his young days. 1 year after 1 year, then the child finds Islam is not important. Iman, belief, is in the heart. Nothing to do with the action. Nothing to do with my dress. Nothing to do with my partner as a wife. Nothing to do with my business. Nothing to do with my earning. Islam is in the heart. If I have time, I pray. If I don't have time, Allah is forgiving. This is what they teach them. And for those who are loyal and they have pressure from their parents even to wait and to attend that session about religion, which is in the end of the week, at the last session of the week, to make it more hated among its people, those who will sit, what would they learn? I will tell you what they teach them. They teach them Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, we love him very much, and you must love him very much, so it's good. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to the people because they worshipping idols, stones and wood. And look, we are not worshipping stones and wood. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he came to tell people not to bury their daughters in the sand. And look, we are not burying our daughters in the sand. And then that was Islam. And he told them to pray 5 times a day. Finish. So a child knows that it's easy. Well, we are in full Islam. Then he grew up, and he grew up, and as he grew up, he will find encouragement from the society to study everything but Islam. Because Islam will become like a chain on his neck. He can't have a free movement. He can't fly, means being politician. He can't dance, means being a fascist. Islam will stop him from all that. He can't communicate. He can't mix. So he can't be elevated in the society. So he wants a job. So he wants to learn a subject in the school for a job to make him earning a lot of money, gaining a lot of respect, and he's one of the key figures or one of the figures in his community, in his society, in his family. What does he learn? Does he learn again about religion to become like that humiliated teacher he was teaching him at school? Never. He will never. Unless he's evil and he's willing to learn about the religion to do some magic and to divide between husband and his wife and to make a woman to love a man and a man love a woman, like the people who are selling the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for nothing, he will never be interested to learn about religion. So those who are learning religion in our country, they are either evil or the people call them fools, because they turn their backs to the treasures and the leisure of the society. Then he goes to learn what? He goes to learn about law. Which law? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam law? No. He goes to learn about John Charlie Rebecca and Teresa and John Major law. He goes to learn about the law of kufr. And you end up with millions of solicitors, men, women. You end up with millions of people who are learning again the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you tell them, brother, this is the law of non-Muslim people. This is opposing the law of Islam. How come they learn? You send your children to learn that law. He says, look, a Muslim should be strong. A Muslim should learn how to defend himself against the kafir law. And who said there should be a kafir law? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us to this earth that should not be a kafir law. And if it's not to be erased by mouth, it should be erased by other than the mouth. Subhanallah. Hundreds of people. This is what they teach the children since they are young. They go 5 years old, easy, more. They can become the strict followers of the Sahaba. They can become assets to their parents in this life and also in the hereafter. Then they become the enemies of Islam when they grow up. Can anybody imagine that his child is going to be the enemy of Islam, one of the followers of the Pharaoh, even though he has a Muslim name? No. But gradually he will be. And some of your children are now, because you left them loose in a society of no Islamic control. And you can see with your own eyes, whenever the government announced about a court which is ruling by other than Allah's law is going to be established or built in any corner, instead of Muslims raising banners and go and destroy it, what do? They raise to apply contracts. Give me the canteen, please. Give me the coffee shop, please. Give me the newspaper shop, please. Everybody wants to make benefit out of kufr. Then who's going to fight the kufr? And who's going to establish the Islam? Everybody is racing to make benefit out of kufr. And when you tell them this is haram, then what do you want us to do? Do you want my child to study all these years? And in the end, when you apply the Islamic State, he will be jobless and he will be a crook. His certificate is not accepted, and you want to get some Mawlawis to rule. Now is to rule to put us in paradise better than yourself to rule to put us in the fire hell. Subhanallah. Where are we from the Sahaba? Where they used to pay a ransom for their own selves just to catch with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Did you hear that Sahabi when he went, he had money and he had wealth and he had goods and he was going to immigrate to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the Kafirs caught up with them. They catch him. They said, no, you came to us poor. You came to us very needy, and now you are rich, and you're going to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You're going to him with all this money? No way. He said, I will give you the money, but let me go to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he told them about his money. They took all his money. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Rabah al Bay'a. Indeed, you were successful. Indeed, you were successful. Look at the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Those who follow him, they pay a ransom for their own self just to be saved. Just to catch the caravan of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And how much we pay to jump from that caravan. And how much we pay to slow down that caravan. And how much we pay to have the same color as the caravan at one phase and the same color as the kafirs at the other back, in our back, at the other face, just to show the right color when we need it. When we are in the mosque, we show the color of a Muslim. When we are among the kafir, it's the suit and the tie and ha 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 among the kafir. Where is Islam? Who's going to establish Islam? Those are the enemies of Islam. So for God's sake, for Allah's sake, if you can't remove their evil, get away from them. Don't make benefit out of them. Between them and the victorious party, there is a big war. And whoever is going to be in the zone of war is going to be consumed. So if you are not one of the victorious party, you are ready to be consumed. Going to that zone to be consumed or consume the kafirs. Get out, because you're going to be in the zone, in the war zone. Don't cry about your money, your wealth, and your wife and your children if you are in a war zone. If you can't be from the Mujahideen, get out. There is a job for the Mujahideen to remove these dirty people. Those are worse than the original Catholic Jewish Christians, because they have tasted Islam and they've decided kufr, and they've decided to establish kufr. Do you know what is Islam? And do you know how to fight Islam? And this is why people like myself and some of my brothers are here asking the protection of original Kafirs against, asking their protection for us to deliver the speech of Rasulullah, even though they hated most. But yet they have some mercy upon, they look at us as human beings, not as Muslims, that these human beings have right to speak. But the apostates in our country, they have no mercy for any human being or for even a Muslim. So this is the situation now. There is a war between the victorious party and these kind of people. If you cannot be from the victorious party and you are not from apostates, then leave that soon. Even if you have to be cool, because you are not a target. You are in a target area. We are hearing a lot of wailing now, a lot of crying about people. Look, innocent people getting killed, innocent people allowing themselves to be a shield for the tyrants to hide behind them and shoot at the victorious party. No, this is not allowed. We can't get rid of this first enemy of Islam unless we do fight them, all the minimum, leave the war zone and let the soldiers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get rid of them. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us enjoy the Islamic State. And it will be dearly paid for, because we are paying for our laziness and the accumulative laziness from our parents and grandparents and grand-grandparents, whom they left Islam to go bit by bit until the debts become very heavy in our shoulders. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from His soldiers. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us enjoy the bounty of seeing the tyrants of Islam leaving earth, humiliated. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make our children the followers of the Sahaba. And make us the followers of the Sahaba. And give us patience, Allah, He give the patience of the Sahaba. And give us blessing as He gave the Sahaba. Allahumma ighfir lana wal mu'minina wal mu'minat. Al ahya'u minhum wal amwat. Allahumma nawwir ala ahli al-qubur min al-muhajirin quburahum. Allahumma ighfir lil ahya'i wa yassir lahum umurahum. Allahumma ruddana ilayka raddan jamila. Ibadallah, inna Allah amarana bi amrin faqad. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima.